Epilepsy can cause random seizures, and it affects nearly 3.5 million people in the U.S. Tonight, a look at a medical procedure that has given a young Stockton woman her life back.
As we see now from KCRA3's Will Hereford, advances now in the control of epileptic seizures have some people living a near normal life.
They last 30 seconds to a minute, and it feels just like impending doom.
29-year-old Hannah Thomas was in college when what she thought were panic attacks were diagnosed as epileptic seizures.
Sometimes I'd have a few a day. I'd go a day without having them, and then I'd have like 5 in one day.
For nearly 6 years, her condition didn't improve.
I learned after trying numerous medicines and combinations that my epilepsy is resistant to medication.
Medication and surgery were not an option, but there was one more chance.
And then Dr. Rao introduced me to this and said, I think you're the perfect candidate. And at that point, I had nothing else to lose, so I just went for it.
The Dr. Rao she is referring to is neurologist Vikram Rao of UC San Francisco.
For about 2/3 of people, they can actually get their seizures under control with medications alone. Unfortunately, Hannah was not one of those people. We tried a lot of things, and her seizures persisted.
Dr. Rao recommended putting an implant into Hannah's head that could possibly relieve her seizures.
With wires that go into the brain, and we place the wires at the site or sites where seizures come, sort of the epicenter of the seizure, if you want to think in earthquake terms.
In this animation from the device maker, NeuralPace, you can see the monitor detecting the onset of a seizure. The unit sends electrical pulses to the area to stop the seizure.
If it hears that a seizure is about to start, it responds to that detection by delivering some electrical pulses to the seizure focus. And those pulses can serve to quiet down the seizure, maybe stop it in its tracks before it actually causes the individual any trouble.
For Hannah, the implant has been a godsend.
Yeah, I'm slowly dipping my toes back in the pond. I'm going to continue my education.
And getting back to what her life was before the onset of seizures includes being able to drive again, thanks to technology that watches over her.
It's like night and day. Before, it was almost like I didn't see a light at the end of the tunnel. And now I know that there's something for me.
In Stockton, Will Hereford, KCRA3 News.
Since that implant procedure, Hannah has had very few seizures. When she does have them, they are much less severe. As you heard, she had put her education on hold, and she now plans to go back to college. She wants to study social work.
What an incredible story.
Yes.
Wow, good for her.